what's going on, New Birth? How y'all feeling? Such an honor. It's an honor of our time, your pastor, Pastor Jamal Bryan. Make some noise for him. Listen, if I know him at all, I know that this church is probably used to raw, honest, unfiltered talk. And I got to give y'all a little bit of my own. 2020 was a year where so much was shut down, so much was weird. I was still able to sing and do ministry in a lot of places, but I have to tell you, most of those places were clubs and theaters, and I took the worship, I took Jesus into weird places. So I gotta admit something. It's kind of weird for me to be in church today. I'm so used to having to sing with a bar in the back of the room that to see just nothing but praisers and worshipers and crosses and preachers and bishops, it's kind of weird for me. I would go and be on my way to stage, and somebody in the kitchen staff would be like, "Jonathan, I want to tell you good luck up there." And I'm like, you know I don't need luck, right? You know I'm up here on something a little more unconditional, something a little more satisfying than just luck. That's the love of God. I need everybody in the room just to encourage yourself and say, I'm not lucky. I'm loved. Can y'all jump up on your feet? Let's just dance a little bit together. Hey, come on. See, maybe I succeeded a little. I jumped up from the floor to the middle. You think I want the credit? I don't. 'Cause the glory ain't made for me. Oh, no. But I know who sits on the throne, who makes the stage and writes the songs. And I know I couldn't do this on my own. And as much as I complain, I've seen more sunshine than rain. And I could thank my lucky stars, but that's not where my blessings are. No, they come from the Father's heart, not the sky, not chance. The truth is, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Come on, let me all sing that. Say, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Yeah, see, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Yeah, today I'm in a happy place, and I know it didn't happen by mistake. I love how he wrote my life, and I love how he sees my heart. So I fall to my knees and I say that I'm grateful when every morning starts. So I don't think my lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are. No, they come from the Father's heart, not the sky, not chance. The truth is, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Come on, New Birth, let me y'all sing and say, from the very beginning, this life that I'm living was part of your plan all along. Oh, so I don't thank my lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are. No, they come from where? The Father's heart, yeah. Not the sky, not chance. Come on, New Birth, I'm not lucky, come on. Put a smile on your face, say, your voice and lift it up. Say, see, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Say, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Everybody that went to Sunday school, just go ahead and lift this up. Everybody say yes, Jesus, he loves me. Come on, let me all sing it. Everybody say yes, Jesus, he loved me. Everybody say yes, Jesus. my lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are. No, they come from the Father's heart, not the sky, not chance. The truth is, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. If you know that to be true about your life, go ahead, make some noise for Jesus. One thing I learned about myself, I'm not in as good a shape as I thought I was. I'm skinny, but even that song with this jacket and turtleneck on took a little bit out of me, took a little bit out of me. Lord, I thank you for another year, for choosing to leave me here. And I pray that you make your plans clear to us. Remind us that you're always near to us. Prosperity. It's a new season and it's coming to me. If you believe that for yourself, sing it with me. Oh, say it's a new season. Yeah, it's a new day. There's a fresh anointing that's flowing my way. Oh, it's a season of power and prosperity. It's a new season, it's coming, because I'm ending these. New birth in 2021, can we put an end to some cycles? This last year, tell me what I missed, 'cause I feel that it's coming back up again. Must be something I ate, some song, some show, some hate. The devil wants to extend the game. Free throws, and when it ends, he wants to make a sequel. 'Cause if he gets another chance, he feels like he can take my joy, my peace, my faith. See, the devil, he learns from your mistakes, even if you don't. That's how he keeps you in cycles, cycles. He tries to keep us in cycles, cycles. I don't know about you, but I ain't going in cycles. I refuse to stay in. Oh, I'm not going in. I'm not going in. Hey, ooh, so Lord, hey. Be free from all of my past sins. See, your love is enough. help me break these cycles. New Birth, go ahead and shout him out. Help me break these
cycles.
I refuse to stay in
cycles.
Lord, get us out of these
cycles.
Lord, break us out of these
cycles.
Oh, generational
cycles.
Oh, economics
cycles.
Oh, no, I'm not going in
cycles.
I refuse to stay in
cycles.
Oh, hey, help us get out of
cycle.
New year, new president, no
cycle.
Oh, I'm not going in
cycle.
Oh, of depression deep
cycle.
Oh, of loneliness deep. Oh, I'm not going inside. I'll tell you why. 'Cause there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every cycle, to break all these cycles. Go ahead, shout them out. Help me break these
cycles.
Come on, it's early in the year. Go ahead and declare that right now. Oh, I have broken some
cycles.
I have ended some discontinued song. I'm not going in. Oh, 'cause it's a new season. It's a new day. It's a fresh anointing that should be coming my way. It's a season of power. Yeah, it's a season of power. Oh, it's a season of power. That means over your emotions in this season. Y'all gotta declare that. Come on, say, it's a season of power. That means what made you mad last year, it ain't gonna work this year. Come on, declare that. It's a season of power. That means over sin, over temptation. Come on, declare. It's a season of power. That means over stress, over anxiety. Come on, New Birth. It's a
season of power
over your ex. It's a season of power, then prosperity. It's a new season, and it's coming because I'm ending Birth. If you know that you're into some cycles this year, go ahead and lift up your hands and worship him. Right there, I need you to go ahead and fill the room with your worship. Your own will can't do it. Changing their name in your phone, that's a good start, but it's not going to end it for you. We have to put Jesus in all those places that other things were. So go ahead and lift up your worship, your praise right there in this moment. Lord, you've been so good. Where would I be without you? Help me break some cycles. 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 We gotta end some cycles. Cycles. I realized in 2020, even going to church can still be part of a cycle. If you leave here and everything's the same, then going to New Birth and listening to the genius Pastor Bryant is just a part of your routine. I'm praying that this year, I don't know how honest I can be up here, Pastor Bryant. So I'm just gonna gloss over and put it up in a nice little Jesus bow. there's some things, there's some people that were in places where God should be. And I gotta make sure that I move them out of the way. Jesus, you're my number one. You can move it over. and I make time for every little thing that I want. I choose my priorities, and Jesus, you're my number one. All the worshipers in the room, just lift up your hands and begin to just make room with your worship. Make room with your praise. Oh, I will. For me, that meant my Instagram time, you can. Facebook time, you can. Tweeting time, you can. Netflix time, you can. Bridgerton time, you can just move it over. Oh, I will make room. Lord, I really want you to move it. Really want you to move.
So God, tonight we declare that we're moving everything detrimental to make room for what is beneficial. There's some things we're moving over. There's some things we're moving out so we can make space for your presence and for your glory. Now, God, tonight, Let the glory that's on the scene be felt through the screen. Holy Spirit, have your way tonight. Use me for your own good pleasure. I move every bit of myself out of the way. And I give you all of me tonight. Breathe on us, breath of God. Fill me with life anew, that I may love what thou dost love and do what thou dost do. In the name of Jesus, let miracles take place tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, you may be seated if you're in the studio. And to all of you who are watching us on every streaming platform tonight, we give God the glory, the honor, and the praise. Would you help me applaud and appreciate and celebrate my covenant brother, who I love to eternity and back, will fight you over and for, the wonderful pastor of the New Birth Church. I want you to holler all over the globe so we can hear you, for Pastor Jamal Harrison Bryant. We celebrate him. The New Birth Church. Then I am so glad, you know, there's a fabulous five, and all of us are here tonight except for Bishop Sapp, who couldn't make it. But I honor my two other covenant brothers tonight, Bishop William Murphy, who is here from the Dream Center, my other covenant brother, and Pastor Antonio Matthews flew all the way from Denver just to hang out with the brothers tonight. And so, Sap, we missing you, man. We missing you. But we're all here in this place. I am so honored to be back here at the New Birth Church. And your pastor gave away my last Sunday of the year slot. And he trying to make up for it by bringing me here tonight. So, no, I'm just playing. But we are just honored to be here in what has been an amazing week for you here at New Birth. We know God has tremendously, and Jonathan McReynolds, my Lord. Woo! What an incredible gift, what oil. And so we thank God. I'm just glad, listen, when you step on the plane like I did today and the flight attendant said to me, Mr. McKissick, it's so good to see you back after 11 months. This is the first time I've been on a plane in 11 months. And I pled the blood of Jesus, Lysol, everything else when I was on that plane. So I'm glad to be here on tonight. Hey, listen, I want to go to a very familiar story in the New Testament. Let's go to an old well and see if we can come up with some fresh water. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 5. Pastor John Paul McGee, my nephew, he's here as well. The Hope Fellowship Church, I'm so glad to see my nephew in the house on tonight. Luke chapter 5, beginning at verse 1. Hear the words of this familiar story. So it was, as the multitude pressed about him to hear the word of God, that he stood by the lake of Gennesaret, and saw two boats standing by the lake, but the fishermen had gone from them and were washing their nets. Then he got into one of the boats, which was Simon's, and asked him to put out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the multitudes from the boat. When he had stopped speaking, he said to Simon, "Launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch." But Simon answered and said to him, "Master, we have toiled all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I will let down the net." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their net was breaking. So they signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled the boats so that they began to sink. On this last night, I want to talk with the aid and the help of the Holy Spirit about let's try it again. Let's try it again. There's an old adage that says, quitters never win, and winners never quit. That winners are people who know how to fight until they win. Winners are people who know that victories don't always happen overnight, and that victories never come without challenging choices. That is, do I keep going in the face of the obstacles, or do I quit without realizing the obstacle will become an opportunity? Most people that quit do so because they enter into a feeling of futility. We've all heard the phrase, an exercise in futility. And while a state of futility is not a psychiatric diagnosis, it is clearly a debilitating condition of the human spirit. And even though it can be precipitated through various coercive feelings, such as fear, depression, despair, anger, anxiety, it remains really an existential condition more than a psychological or emotional, this feeling of futility. One author has said that futility is best described by one common question we sometimes ask ourselves: what's the point? Many of us are frustrated and disillusioned and fed up, even as we've come into a new year, because we started 2020 with hopes and dreams and goals and aspirations, only to find out in that year that skin was still the sin as far as white people were concerned. A virus had entered our country and many were dying. Businesses became bankrupt. Sickness was at an all-time high. And all of the goals and dreams and aspirations we started 2020 with seemed to be fleeting, and most success, let's be honest, came with a side helping of disappointment and futility and difficulty. This futility, Pastor Bryant, does not limit itself to particular generations. It goes from Generation Z's struggle to find their place in the world and get on the economic ladder, all the way through Generation X in their midlife crisis, down to the baby boomer encounter with the ultimate meaning of their lives. Everybody deals at some point with the exercise in futility. It has been a year, 2020, wasn't it? A year where things didn't go as we planned. But I've come with a word for somebody tonight watching me. The word tonight is, don't allow your former conclusions to influence present actions. That's my word tonight. Don't allow what hasn't worked to determine what can't work. In the text, we see an example of what I'm talking about, of how Jesus refuses to allow quitting and futility to be an option in the life of every believer. Jesus has been walking on the lake and stops, and he gets into one of two boats that are docked by the lake. And Murphy, I'm an analytical kind of preacher. I'm an analytical kind of exegete. And so I often paint pictures in my mind of the geography and topography of a text, particularly when it's a story. And my question that was not a part of the text, but it was a part of the drama, because Matthew's version tells us he passed by a whole bunch of boats and then chooses Simon's. And my question was, why his boat? He passes all of these other boats. All of them are docked. Everybody's washing their nets. And yet he chooses Simon's boat. And the Bible never tells us, never gives us an answer. But I want to suggest something to you that the Holy Spirit said to me. I don't know why Jesus chose his boat, but I do know it was intentional. Now, that doesn't even sound like much, but I'm fixing to give you your first opportunity to throw your phone across the room. You are blessed by intention. You have survived by intention. You are still here by intention. You didn't just slip up on a blessing. You didn't get a blessing because you just happened to be in the room where other people were being blessed and some of theirs spilled over onto you. You didn't get blessed by accident. accident. You are blessed because of the intentionality of God. You better hear what I just said. You weren't blessed because of who you know. You weren't blessed because somebody hooked you up. You weren't blessed because you happened to walk in the right room. You were blessed by intention, that Jesus stopped by your boat and said, this is the boat that I want to bless. That's why you don't have to explain it or justify it or even act like you shouldn't have it. The devil is a liar. I can justify it because I got it by intention. Can I make an announcement to everybody watching me? This year, you will not have to explain, justify, or act like you have the blessings that God has for you. This is the year. You ain't explaining nothing. You ain't justifying nothing. You ain't acting like you shouldn't have it. You got it by intention. I dare you just, yeah, I know you can't yell, but I'm blessed by intention. That's how I'm blessed. I ain't got to explain it to you because my blessing ain't at the argument of your opinion. God stopped by my boat. And I want to tell somebody, 2021 is the year God's choosing your boat. That should have made you shout all the way over in Africa. This is the year where God's going to say, not them, not them, not them, not them, not them. Not them, you. Yes, this ain't a high five your neighbor. This is a high five yourself and say, this is the year he chooses my. He's choosing my boat. He's choosing my boat. He's choosing. Here's the other thing. Antonio, we get so busy teaching people how to get the fish that we miss the prerequisite. You can't get the fish till he gets the boat. Okay. I know in this day of supercilious pep rally preaching, where the preacher is nothing more than a cheerleader leading you in cute charismatic cheers. But I came to tell you today, this ain't the year for you to just go after fish. This is the year for you to give him the boat. Because you can't get the fish till you give him. Yes, I know I'm messing with somebody right now, but I came to tell you, if you give him the boat, he's already got the fish waiting on you. If you give him the boat, he's already called every blessing, every check, every promotion, every house, every healing, every breakthrough. It's already waiting on you. All you've got to do is give him the boat. So he gets in the boat. He starts teaching. And then after he teaches, he gives Simon these instructions to put out a little, let down your nets for a catch. And when Jesus gives the instruction, y'all know the story. Simon follows it up with an excuse. We did that all night at the time you supposed to do it. You telling us to do it out of order. Pastor Brian, I know this is your small studio, and forgive me if anybody tears up the studio right quick on this side street, a revelation I want to give somebody. Simon said, we did it all night, which is the time we're supposed to do it. This ain't the time, Jonathan. This is not the order in which we should put down nets. But Jesus said, if you obey me, I'm getting ready to do some stuff out of order. I'm going to do it in an order that everybody else said it shouldn't be done. The order said you ought to have the credit before you get the house. The order says you ought to have the money before you get the car. The order says you ought to have the degree before you get the job. But I came to make a prophetic declaration. 2021 is the year God's going to do some stuff out of order. God, I feel the Holy Ghost. Now, the thing that caught my eye, Jay, wasn't what Simon was saying, but what Simon was doing. He was washing his nets. He was washing his nets, because washing your nets was a sign you were done. You were through. It was finished. You quit. He was washing his nets, which was a sign he was done. He was through. He was finished. He had quit. So that in a real sense, Jesus, John Paul, it was his emptiness that caused him to quit. Oh God, he wasn't washing his nets because he had a good catch. He was washing his nets because they were empty and filled with nothing but trash. And that's where the enemy wants us. He wants your emptiness to lead you to feeling like you can't make it. He wants your emptiness to make you quit. He wants your emptiness to make you feel like you're done. But then he wants to compound your conflict by showing you all the trash you caught while trying to catch fish. Trashy relationships, trashy jobs, trashy house hunting, trashy friendships, trashy ways of thinking. And when it keeps coming up empty, he convinces you to give up, because emptiness has a way of pushing you to quit. I mean, when you've been working and you got the right skills and you got the right tools and the net keeps coming up empty, that emptiness will put you in a place of frustration, because I refuse to keep doing this and coming up empty. Who am I talking to tonight watching me? Who has just quit because you're tired of trying and coming up empty? I came by on a Thursday night to tell you that the Lord is coming tonight to tell you, let's try again. When you say done, God said, no, you're not. When you say I ain't going back, God says, yes, you are. God will make you eat your word. Let me tell you something. Be careful who and what you declare you're finished with. Because you might be walking away from your greatest blessing that's in the making. Try it again. That's my declaration to somebody about 2021. Yes, Murphy, try it again. Yeah. That's my declaration to you watching me all the way in Africa. Try it again. This is going to be the year where you're going to get some stuff done that hasn't worked in your life in the past. Let me give you a couple of principles. I ain't gonna keep you long. If you're going to try again, you've got to know the power of placement. Okay, look at where they are when Jesus finds them, and then what they have to do in order to try again. Okay, look at where they are when Jesus finds them, where they have to go to try again. They got to go back to the place where they tried and failed. He doesn't take them to a new place. Jesus. God help me. He doesn't take them to a new job or a new opportunity or a new marriage. Oh, I knew y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm all the way here by myself, and I know you ain't saying nothing. He says, if you gonna get this blessing, you got to trust me enough to go back to the place where you tried and failed. But to do that, they have to leave from the place where they have settled, the shore. You're going to leave. Listen, if you're going to try again, you got to leave the place where you settled and go to the place where you're expecting. Yes. Woo. See, sometimes blessings don't come, or you don't get them, listen, or you aren't prepared for them because you have not left where you have settled. He says, now that I'm done teaching, watch this, put out a little further. Disconnect from everybody you've been close to. Jesus. Disconnect from everybody you've been hanging out with on the shore. Disconnect from all the other net washers. Because while they may be through, you ain't. God help me preach it. I just said something should have made somebody run. Yeah. See, you got to disconnect from people who keep acting like it's over and acting like they can't make it and acting like God ain't going to bless them. You got to say, this is the year where I got to disconnect from you because you might be done, but I'm not. Hey, the problem in your life for why you aren't more blessed than you are just might be. And just might have something to do with disconnect and distance. You still hanging out at the shore with other net washers. See, because some people can only handle you when you are still at the level where they met you. Preach Rudolph McKissick. He's just... Some folk gonna get mad with you in 2021 when you decide shore time is over because they can only handle you at the level where they met you. Some folk are gonna start blocking you. They just did you a favor. Some folk are gonna walk away from you because you've decided you tired of the shore life and they can only handle you at the level where they met you. Some of y'all got deep water value but keep dealing in shoreline relationships. You keep letting folk treat you like a discount when you never should have been on the sales rack. I feel your Holy Ghost. I feel your Holy Ghost. This is the year that I need you to declare in 2021, I am not created for the shore. Come on, I need you to get that in your spirit. I need you to prophesy with your thumbs on Facebook. I am not created for the shore. I need you to open your mouth and declare it unto the Lord. I am not created for the shore. The shore is safe space. The shore is where you gain nothing. The shore is where you started, but that ain't where God's trying to end you. It's time for you to leave the shore. Go to something deeper. It, place matters. Let me keep going. If you're gonna trust Jesus to launch and try again, you can't fear failure. Failure is one of the enemy's greatest tools he uses against the child of God. I need you to get this. And it's one of the tools he uses to keep the child of God in stagnation. Because we have not figured out that I'm only a failure when I allow what failed to define my value. Things fail. I don't. Because you win some, and you learn some. But you lose none. I'm talking to somebody in here because my value ain't defined by what failed. I only become a failure if I become what my failing said I should be. So we began to think that whatever area has been a failure is an area where we can never have success. Marriage, going back to school, opening the business, getting the promotion, parenting, Jesus, getting pregnant after years of fear. God, I felt that in the Holy Ghost right there. Getting pregnant again after 5 years of futility and doctors telling you that it will never happen. Kicking a habit. And if we have not been successful at it, then we sometimes allow the enemy to convince us that success is not for us in that area. But look at the text. Jesus gives them an instruction to do what they've already done and failed at it. Here's what I want to tell you tonight. God, Jesus, is going to bless you in some areas where you have been frustrated by failure. Come here. God's getting ready to bless you in some areas where you've been frustrated by failure, because this time you've got something extra that you did not have before. This time you're doing it on divine timing. See, sometimes it wasn't a bad choice, it was just a bad time. Preach, boy. Sometimes it wasn't a wrong choice, it was just the wrong time. And you've got to have such a faith that can say, no matter how bad it was the last time, God's about to give me another chance. This is my time. And this is my turn, and I'm gonna do it again. Who am I talking to watching me tonight on Facebook or on the website or on YouTube or on Instagram? You've had some jacked up situations, and you've had some things you thought would have produced by now, but they have not produced. But God tuned you in on a Thursday night to say, let's do it again, let's try it again, let's get another chance. Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Here goes my analytical mind again, Murphy. So, Jesus has blessed him by intention. And which means he got in the boat with the intention of not giving him fish, but getting him. So he gets in the boat and he teaches. And then after he teaches, he says, now let's launch out. Now, I had a question. Jesus, if it was your intention to get in his boat because you wanted him as your disciple and you were going to use the miracle of trying again to get him on the team, why was the teaching necessary? The text doesn't tell us why, but can I give you just my deductive exegesis? The text says that when Jesus came upon them, they were washing their nets. God, this is good. I believe, Tone, that Jesus taught long enough for them to finish cleaning their nets. Because you can't take dirty nets to new opportunities. God help me. And the reason some of y'all can't get your life together is because God's trying to give you new opportunities, but you keep trying to go to it with dirty nets, with old thinking, with old habits, with dysfunctional relationships, with toxic connections. But I came to tell somebody, before the clock strikes zero, you go clean your net tonight and get ready for your catch. Now watch. I did some study because I knew I was coming to Dr. Jamal Harrison Bryant's church, maybe my best friend, but he's an Oxford graduate. He's a wordsmith. So I did some study and I discovered that the transliteration of the Greek koinonia text, the most accurate and authentic transliteration of this particular story, is the New King James Version. I use NIV most of the time, but I did a deep dive exegesis because I knew where I was coming. And I discovered that the New King James Version is the closest, most authentic English transliteration to the Greek Koinonia text. So with that in mind, I want you to watch something. And please don't throw your phones at me. Jesus says to Simon, launch out into the deep and cast out your nets for a catch. Simon says to Jesus, we did this all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I'll let down the net. You didn't get it in Texas. Let me come back to y'all in about 3 minutes. Come back. Jesus said, let down your nets for a catch. Simon said, we did that. Nevertheless, at your word, I'll let down the net. Come here. Jesus said, let down your nets, Jesus, for a catch. Simon said, we tried that all night, Jesus. So here's what I'm going to do, Jesus. I'm going to try it halfway and see how that works. And if that works,
works, I'll put down the other nets. See, the problem with some of y'all is that you keep dummying down your expectation because of your past experience, and you keep semi-trying God instead of all the way trying God. And tonight I came to tell you, whatever you thought it was going to be, it's going to be bigger. Whatever you thought you were going to catch, it's going to be greater. And I need you to holler in your house. I need you to holler in this studio, because you know whatever you were thinking, God said, I'm about to do bigger than that.
I'm about to do bigger than that. Can I give y'all the real shout? Now, I know it's a few of y'all in the studio, and y'all probably won't nobody know that y'all in here, but can I give y'all the real shout? This ain't for all the bad and bougie raindrop drop top Baptists. No, this for all the keep it real folk right here. Here's what I love about Jesus. Simon only partially obeys but gets full blessing. Come here. You didn't say it because you've been saved all your life. But how many of y'all can shout that even when I didn't do what he told me to do, he blessed me anyhow? Even when I didn't act right, he blessed me anyhow. Do you know why you ought to be running all over your house? Because in 2020, you didn't do everything he told you to do, but he kept on blessing you, kept on opening doors, kept on making ways.
I gotta go.
Look at somebody under your mask and just tell them, try it again. Text somebody if you're watching me. Come on, text somebody. Tell them, try it again. Here's the last thing, and I'm done. Here's the last thing, and I'm done.
There are going to be opportunities in your overflow.
Tim, they just like Bethel. They didn't know. They didn't even know to shout in the principal.
There are going to be opportunities in your overflow.
Y'all still didn't get the prophetic pronouncement in the principal. There are going to be opportunities in your overflow. Y'all still didn't get it. I just prophesied something on you, and you didn't even get it. See, you thought the key word was opportunities. No, baby. The key word was overflow. I came to make somebody shout that 2021, if you are obedient to what God says, is going to be the year of your overflow. It's going to be the year of your exceeding abundance. This is the year where, watch it.
Let me use my studio voice. The Bible declares that Simon caught so many fish that the net couldn't handle it. So he calls his partners. Oh, this is good. He calls his boys, whose boat was right next to his on the shore, as they were washing. And he calls them, because they're still there, to come get some of these fish. Jesus. His partners who are still hanging there with him. See, I ain't afraid of losing. Can I tell y'all what I'm really afraid of? I'm more afraid of having the wrong folk on my side when I'm winning.
I need the right partners, Jesus. I need the right folk who are still there, who are still sticking with me, who haven't finished what they were doing and gone home, who haven't left me by myself because I was still washing my nets. Please don't miss this. Don't deal with folk who are not willing to keep their boat next to yours when your net is empty. Come here. Don't you deal with people who only want you when your net is full. Don't you connect yourself to people who only want to be connected to you when you are free. If you can't be with me when my net is empty, then don't come hollering for me when my net gets full. If you can't be with me when I ain't got a job, I ain't got a dime, I barely got a bed to lay my head down in,
in, you stay right where you are. Because if you don't want me when I'm empty, you can't have me when I'm full.
There's some folk that walked away from you
because they thought you wasn't nothing but an empty net carrier. There's some people who decided they didn't want nothing to do with you because they thought you were nothing but an empty net carrier. But God sent me all the way to New Birth to tell you, this is the year of the blessing of overflow. And when it comes to the folk that walked away from you, you don't need to show off for them. You don't need to send them pictures. You don't need to post nothing on Facebook. You just march in your blessing, because he prepares a table in the very presence of your enemies. And you ain't got time to fight when it's time to eat. You just enjoy. I came to make a declaration. 2021 is going to be the year where God is going to bless you enough to bless everybody that stuck with you. That's my declaration tonight. Everybody that stuck with you, everybody that hung with you, he's gonna bless them with your overflow. That means your children are gonna get blessed. Your marriage is gonna get blessed. Your family is gonna get blessed. I want y'all to do something real bold. I want you to take your phone out and I want you to text three people and tell them, whatever you do, stick with me this year. Come on, don't be afraid. Take your phone right now and find three people and tell them, whatever you do, stick with me this year. I know it's been rough. I know I've been empty. I know it's been futile. I know it looked like it wasn't gonna work. But this is the year where I give him my boat. And this is the year where he gives me his fish. So whatever you do, stick around. With me. I got to leave y'all alone, but I wish you could high five your neighbor, but just high five yourself and say, self, I'm getting ready to bless everybody that's connected to me. My children will not go wanting. My marriage will not go empty. My family will get all their bills paid. My church will get the mortgage canceled, because when God blesses me, God, I said I wasn't gonna do it, but I done slipped in my happy place, because I know what it means to go through years of empty nets where it looked like you couldn't get your life together. But I told the Lord, 2021 is gonna be my year to bless everybody that's connected to me. I need somebody who ain't ashamed tonight to shout real quick, because you're going to bless everybody that's connected to you. Your family's blessed. Your marriage is blessed. Your church is blessed. Your mind is blessed. Good night, New Birth. May the Lord God bless you real good. But is there anybody in here who can help me close this sermon and just say, this is my year to bless everybody else. This is my year to bless my neighbor. I know you can't do it, but I need you to do it in the spirit. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, neighbor, oh, neighbor, this is my year. That was the wrong neighbor, child. Text somebody else. Call somebody else and tell them, neighbor. Lord have mercy. Neighbor, I'm getting ready to bless somebody else. So Lord, here's my boat. Here's my life. Here's my mind. Here's my thoughts. I just just need one witness that can testify tonight. If you give him the boat, he'll give you the fish. If you give him your life, he'll give you the blessing. If you give him your heart, he'll give you the increase. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he fight your battles? Won't he make your enemies your footstool? Won't he give you joy and sorrow? Won't he give you hope for tomorrow? Won't he dry your tears? Won't he, won't he, won't he, won't he, won't he, won't he? I'm sorry, y'all. And because I know my blessing is on the way, because I know my miracle is on the way, I'm not gonna wait till the battle's over, but I'm shouting right now. And is there anybody in revival tonight that ain't ashamed? Take your phone out and just text somebody and tell them the fish are coming. The fish are coming. The miracles are coming. The blessings are coming. The breakthrough is coming. And I got a feeling that somebody in the room is ready for your miracle. You're ready for your blessing. And I got to get out of here, but I just need a few partners who can join me in giving God the praise. I don't know if you're in Africa. I don't know if you're in Europe. I don't know if you're in Florida, but I'm calling you. Come get this blessing. Come get this miracle. And I need somebody to wave your hand. If you're ready for the overflow, wave your hand. If you're ready for the increase, and I don't want to be by myself. Let the redeemed of the Lord open up your mouth, throw back your head, and say, I'm ready for the overflow. I'm ready for the increase. Say, yeah, yeah, yeah. And I want somebody to get on your feet, throw your hands, because when the praises go up and the obedience goes forth, the blessings, it's time for your miracle. It's time for your breakthrough. It's time for your increase. And I'm not gonna wait till the battle's over. Shout, shout, shout. Yeah, yes, yes. And I will make room in my boat for my blessing. Say yes, yes. And I declare 2021 is my year. It's my time. It's my time.
This is the year.
Thank you, Lord.
Where not only are you going to try again,
Jesus,
but I declare, I speak net breaking blessings in your bank account. God's going to give you so much money, it's going to look strange in one account. You're going to have to open two and three. God's going to bless you with more than one house. God said you're not just going to open the business, you're going to open locations. God said, I'm not just going to sustain you through chemo, I'm going to dry up the tumor. You've been thinking all you could have was a net. She said, oh no, I'm going to give you net-breaking blessings.
Yes, 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 yes.
On this last night, I declare and decree unto you, try it again. I'm talking to some husband and wife. You've been trying with your fertility to get pregnant. I hear it in the Holy Ghost. God is telling me to tell you right now while you're looking at me, 2021 won't just be the year of pregnancy, it's going to be the year of twins. Because a child is a net, but twins are nets. God told me to tell somebody every promotion you've tried for you didn't get, but that's because it just wasn't the right time. There's a promotion coming open at the place where you work because somebody's getting ready to quit within the next 30 days. And the promotion, watch this, will not be yours because you applied for the job. They're going to come looking for you. This is the year of nets breaking. I hear it in the Holy Ghost. This is a mighty good net y'all built here. But God said, new birth, this ain't enough. I sent Jamal Bryant into that place. Not just to steady the ship, but to break the nets. Don't get it twisted. It's been a good ship. It's been a great ship. But this is the year where the visions that God has given Pastor Brian, he's going to release him to share on a level he's never shared it. And we talk about everything, but we've never talked about this. This is just what I see in the spirit. That this is the year
where everybody that has stuck with him some of y'all walked away because you thought the net was empty. Some of y'all walked away because you thought blogging Negroes could empty his net. But God said there's an anointing and a glory on new birth that everybody that stuck with him is going to receive the benefit of the nets breaking all over this church. Wherever you are at home, I want you to do through the screen what we're going to do on the scene. I want every hand slipped in the air. Woo! Come on, yeah, where you are right now. Where you are right now. Yeah. The hand in the air is a sign of surrender. Because here's the first thing you're doing with the hand in the air. You're giving him the boat. Come on, put your hand, cuz. Some of y'all allowed him on the boat but didn't give him the boat. You've been chasing the fish. Jesus said you're gonna keep coming up empty till you give me the boat. The boat represented Simon's life and livelihood. The boat represented his economic stability. Jesus said, I'm not gonna give you the fish that I've put your name on until you give me your life, your livelihood, your finances, your family, your mind, your weaknesses, your toxicity, your dysfunctions. You're going to surrender that boat to him tonight. Because when you give him the boat, he's going to give you the fish. And God said, I'm not blessing you for you to keep it all to yourself. He said, your blessing is not going to be in the fish you catch, but in the fish you share. Here's what I want to do, and I want you to hear me tonight. Whew. Nets go down in water like seeds go down in dirt. You have to cast a net like you cast a seed. Fish don't come up till nets are thrown. And fruit won't come up till seeds are sown. And I know what the Lord told me. I prayed about it tonight, Jamal, and I told the Lord, Give me the word to speak tonight. And then, God, tell me what to do to help us seal this tonight. There's no magic in a seed, but there sure is faith in it. Your seed is your statement that every promise God has spoken over your life, it may have been delayed, but it is not canceled. Listen to me carefully tonight. You said 23 is y'all's number. There are 23 of you tonight. 23. 23. 22, because I'm first. God told me he'd give me five in the room. There are 23 of you tonight that I want to sow a $450 seed. That's what the Lord gave me tonight. Tonight, you're sowing that not to catch your fish. You're sowing that because you've given the Lord your ship and you know the fish are waiting on you. God said, son, if you do what I tell you to do. And I kept saying, God, that's an awfully large number. He said, listen, if you just exercise your faith, I've already got the fish waiting. There are 23, and there might be at least 23, $450 seed. 22, because I'm one. There's two. God told me he'd give me five in the room. There's three. There's four. Yes, there's five. There's six. That's overflow. That's seven. That's overflow. God told me if you ask for five, I'll give you seven. Yes. I'll never ask you to do what I don't do. Never ask you to do what I won't do. And so right now I'm going to sow mine and listen to me. The rest of you that are in this group, you're going to ignite the net breaking anointing that's on this last night. 23 of you, $450. 23 of you right now. Don't wait, don't hesitate. Can I tell you what really got Simon the blessing? Obedience. And he did not hesitate to obey, because it is obedience that positions you for the supernatural. Just be quick right now and obey. 450. 23 of you right now. This seed is for your children, who are your partners, your spouse, who is your partner, your business partner for your business, your family, who you've been trying to get saved. Right now, right now, right now, wherever you are, right now, right now, right now. Then I want 46 of you to sow a $250 seed. Now, if you don't have that, I'm not talking to you, but if you got it and keep it, you're gonna curse your own seed. Release it unto the Lord tonight, right now. Right now, 23 of you, 450. I've already got 7 in the room. I need at least 16 more of you tonight. Yes, I feel the Holy Ghost. And then 46 of you, 250. Right now, right now, right now. Bishop, I don't have that, but I don't want to be left out. Oh, you're not left out, beloved, because it is not the equality of the gift, but it is the quality of the sacrifice. You don't have 450. You don't have 250. I want you to get as close to $150 as you can tonight. As close as you can. I have discovered in my own life, Jamal, that the greatest stages I have set for the supernatural is when I gave when I thought I couldn't afford to do it. Tonight I'm speaking to somebody who's convincing yourself you can't afford to do it. That's an exercise in futility. Sow it tonight, believing in the supernatural. And watch, the nets are getting ready to break. Come on, all over this studio, all over this world right now. Right now, $450, $250 for 46 of you, and everybody else as close to $150 as you can tonight. This is going to be a nets-breaking offering tonight. You didn't hear what I said, because I know you didn't hear it. Put the coffee down. A nets-breaking offering is coming into new birth tonight. Because we're going to be obedient unto the Lord. And so, Father, I call it blessed. Everyone that has sown in obedience tonight. Everyone that has stretched their faith tonight. Everyone that has been sacrificial tonight. Nets are getting ready to break. Thank you for obedience. Thank you for giving us another chance. Thank you that we can go back to the places where we failed and be as fruitful as we've ever been. And I declare and decree tonight that everybody that stuck with us is about to be blessed. Thank you for everybody that stuck with my brother. Thank you for everybody that stayed by his side. And the miracles and blessings that are in his anointing, that is in his word, that is over his life, is going to be exponentially placed upon everybody that has stuck with him. In Jesus' name we declare it. Amen.